Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is actually a re-record of the Nmap series. I was recording for the part 2 from task 9 to 15, but the light went out, so I'm gonna redo this again. So I already load the attack box. Well, it's loading again. But let's review. Anyways, let's get right into it. It's gonna be task 10, I believe. Is it 10 or? Yeah, it's definitely 10. Because I already did scan types. So we're gonna do task 10 NSE scripts overview. So it talks about different scripts, safe, intrusive, vulnerable. And as you know, guys, I'm just gonna show you how to answer these questions, and I strongly recommend to read through each task. So answer questions below. What language are NSE scripts are written in? Is Lua. You can find it right here. NSE scripts are written in Lua programming language and can be used to do a variety of things, from scanning, automating exports. Last question, which category of scripts would be a very bad idea to run in a production environment? And I put intrusive. As you redo the categories, you can see it says intrusive, not safe, likely to affect the target. Okay. All right, so the next one is task 11, NSE scripts working with NSE. So it talks about the NSE script and talks about the commands. And answer questions below. What are the optional arguments can the ftp-anon.nse script take? So you read through the paragraph. There's NSMap. We can do this. Copy this. All right. So you read through it. So script arguments, FTP anon.max list, the max number of files returned directly listing. So that's why there's max list. All right. Test 12, NSE scripts, scripting for scripts. All right. So these are just various ways of looking, finding scripts. There's the file head, group, list. So, show split view. And this is how you find these answers. So answer questions below. Search for NSB scripts in the /usr/share/nmap/scripts directory using either of the demonstrated methods. What is the file name of the script, which determines the online OS of the NSB server? So let's change cd usr share nmap scripts. All right, so you list OS and SMB, right? So SMB. You read through it, there's this one, SMB OS. So the same thing. So that's how I found this answer. And it says read through the script, what does it depend? So let's clipboard this, copy this. So you can do this file script, hit script. So basically, say file, what kind of file is this? Paste. And let's see, can you read the head? Nope. It's talking about what does it depend? Doesn't show the dependency, so it says to read it, right? So I'm gonna cat it. Oops. So it opens up this file or script, whatever you like to call it. You scroll up, and this is right here, dependency, SMB root. That's how I got the answer. All right, task 13, firewall invasion. So it talks about dash F dash dash MTU, scan delay and bat some. And it's just, answer questions below. Which simple and frequently rely upon protocols often block, requiring the use of that terminate that. Oops, sorry. I meant to exploit. Again, which simple and frequently rely upon protocols often block, requiring the use of the dash PN switch. So as you read right here, PN will still not to bother pinging the host before scanning. This means the Nmap will always treat the target host being alive, effectively bypassing the ICMP block. So I see. And then it says research which Nmap switch allows you to append an arbitrary length of random data at the end of packets. So when it says research, I usually just Google. And it says the arguments dash dash data dash length, which I have. Tells Nmap to generate random bytes and append them as data in the request. So, all right. So task 14, practical. Use what you learn to scan the target machine, answer questions below. Note, if you're not subscribed, make sure this machine has had around 10 minutes to start. So, let's show split view. Answer questions below. Does the target IP respond to ICMP echo pin request, yes or no? So what we're gonna do is ping sweep. So this is just example, Nmap-SN. IP, but we're going to use this one. So. All right. So, what's my IP? So it is. Your IPs might be different, so yeah, 10.10.213.185. And it says no because right here, my address unknown, so I'm not sure. It says perform an XMix scan on the first 99 ports of the target. How many ports are shown to be open or filter. So XMIS, so we're gonna go back to task 8. So it's gonna be XMIS and it says port, right? Dash P 1 through 999 and do that. So Nmap XMIS scan the IP ports. I should space here, didn't I? But it still works. And it says all 99 scan ports are open. So that's why the answer 9. There's a reason given for this dash dash. What is it? The answer will be in your scan results. Think carefully about which switches to use and read the hint before asking for help. Run this command with the dash VV switch enable. It's good practice to always increase reversity in our error scans. And yeah, so it's just no response. If I don't do that, it's going to say so. So that's no responses. And then next question, perform a TCP SYN scan on the first 5,000 ports of the target dash dash. How many ports are shown to be open? So while the dash VV doesn't show you no response. So it's going to be, TCP VV 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's how I got the 5 ports. It says open Wireshark and perform a TCP connect scan against port on the port 80, monitoring the results. Make sure you understand what's going on. Deploy the FTP-ANOT script against the box. Can Nmap login successfully to FTP server on port 21? Okay, let's see. So, TPC connect, and it wants 21. No, it's asking for scripts, right? So it's going to be dash dash script equals save. Or is this one? So I'm going to try dash script. Nmap dash script equals FTP anon, then TCP scan against this IP address, port 81. See, scan unknown. It says allow. So let's try FTP. 10.10.2.1.3.1.8.5. Login fail, remote Unix, but you see, you can log in. Anyways, yes. There you go, guys. That's it. Task 15 conclusion is just answer questions below the conclusion. And it says there's a lot of resources on Nmap. So what's this documentation? Yeah, so nmap.org. Read it on your off time. And yeah, click complete. Hit Twitter, share on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. If you like this video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Notification button, comment on my videos. You like the video, you don't like it. Yeah. So the next one, I'll reset it. It's gonna be network services. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Till the next video. See you.